Good morning, student. How are you? I hope you all are fine. So today we will start our next topic of HTML. In previous videos, I have told you about how we can define the HTML document and what are the sections of HTML document. So today we will start the HTML lecture 2. Now you can understand how we can define the tags and then attributes. Now, headings. In HTML, heading is same like our books heading. Now, we can define the heading in a better manner, bold manner, or we can define the important topics in a form of heading. HTML provide you the six section of headings, H1 to H6. H1 indicate the larger size of font, and the H6 indicate the smaller size of the text. H1 is larger than H2, is smaller than H1, then H3 once again is smaller than H2. So in this form we can define the heading tag in HTML. For defining the heading tag, basically we use the H tag and then we can use corresponding numbers. Okay, fine. Now attribute. We always use tags. Tags are the HTML command. We can define the attributes with HTML tags. Actually, the attribute define the tags behavior, or we can say with the help of attribute you can specify the some functions with the tags. So how we can define the attribute? We can define the attribute with the tag. First we have to write the tag name, then after we can define attribute. In the same time, we can use more than one attribute with the tag using the spacing. Like in this example, I am using the P tag and defining the align attribute and define write. Now, writing the text and then enclose the paragraph tag. So in this way, you can define the attribute with the text. Formatting. Actually, with the help of formatting, you can define the better look or presentations may be more clear with the help of formatting. Basically, formatting tags, there are so many formatting tags available in HTML like p text to define a paragraph, and b tag. With the help of b tag, you can define the bold. According to your need, you can display the text in a bold letter with the help of b tag. I means italic. If you are writing anything within the italicized tag, then the text will be displayed in a italic letter. U tag is used for defining underline format. Similar way you can define this tag. First you have to use the U tag, then after you can write the text, enclose the text, whatever you want to underline. So that text will be enclosed within U tag. Then we can define sub. Sub indicate the subscripted text. And SUP indicate the superscripted text. Now, BR. BR indicate the break a line. But in HTML, if we are pressing the enter not display in the browser or web browser will not read the enter. So in place of enter, you can use the BR tag to break a line. Now, in this example, I am showing this is my first HTML code. And now using the BR, and I am happy. So you can check this output. Okay, this is my first HTML code and I am happy coming in the next line. Next tag is HR tag. Actually, HR tag means horizontal line on your page. So you can use this line to divide the information into different section, or you can use the horizontal ruler within your web page. There are so many attributes we can use with the HR tag. These attributes are, the first is align. Now we can specify the alignment with the horizontal ruler. So how we can define? First we have to use the HR tag, then use the attribute align, and then equals to in double quotes we can define the values. What values we can define? We can define left, right, center according to the our need. If we want to display the in alignment center, then we can choose the center or we can choose left or right. Now we can set the size attribute with the HR tag. Remember it, size means the height of the rule in pixels. A pixels, what is a pixels? small tiny dot that makes up the display of your computer, that is known as pixels. Default value depends directly on the browser. The default size of a ruler is a 3 pixels of size. Size means the height of the ruler. Now width, with the help of width attribute, you can specify the width of the horizontal ruler. By default the value is 100%, but you can change the default value by using the attribute width. You can simply use the HR tag, then give one space, write the width attribute equals to, in double quotes you can define the attribute value like 50% or 70%. It means ki actually you want to specify the length of the horizontal ruler. Now no shade options. Actually this option, so this attribute remove the usual shading effect. By default actually indicate the 3D effects, and but with the help of no shade the ruler will be displayed in a dark or solid line. Color, with the help of color you can specify the color of the horizontal ruler. Comment tag and font tag. With the help of comment tag we can use to insert the text. It will not display in the browser. Remember, it not display in the browser. So what is the purpose of the comment tag? Comment tag only used for explanation. It is help for the user so that you can understand ki what is the purpose of writing this code. We can define the comment tag in a two method, by exclamation mark or with the help of using directly comment tag. Both the options we can use. Now the next is font tag. But we can define different sizes of font. With the help of font, actually the text display more darker, or we can increase or decrease the size of the font. It means ki if we want to change the font size, then we can use the font attribute, font tag with the attribute size. There are three attributes we can use with the font tag, that is size, color and face. With the size attribute you can define the size of the font. With the help of color attribute you can define the color of the font, as well as with the help of face attribute where you can define the name of font tag, name of different types of font. So you can choose any font with the font face attribute. Now we will understand how we can write the HTML code. Now I am showing you the practical HTML. Then I am using the head tag, head, and within the head I am defining the title tag. Within the title HTML lecture. Now close the title tag, then close head tag. Then we can define the body tag. Now we are starting the body from here. We can define with body tag attribute also like BG color. BG color indicate the background color, COLOR equals to, then you can, let's say defining the color is green. If you want to define the text color, then you can also use the attribute text, and then you can write text color like yellow. Now then we can write the one paragraph, like let's say first we start the heading H1. I'm using H1, and then ALIGN align attribute, and let's say center. And then my heading within the web page, like HTML formatting. Okay, now close this H1 tag. Now what I want to underline this heading also, so that I can use the tag underline tag. Okay, so in this manner you can use the tag. Remember it, you tag close first, because we have started H1 first. So you tag close first, and then after we can close H1. H1 tag. Okay, now after H1, let's say I am writing a paragraph. Here I can define, by default the paragraph align attribute use the left alignment. We can change, let's say align equals to, we can define RIGST, right alignment for the paragraph. Here we can write the paragraph. In place of writing paragraph, I am using notepad or any text file from the documents. Let's say in the document, I'll just open a one text file and then copy it here. Documents, from the documents. Text, I'm using text. So that we can insert directly text in place of writing the text, or you can write down the text. Just a minute, it is opening it and taking time. Now I am selecting this text, Control C, and then placing it here, Control V, and then closing the paragraph tag. So in this web page document, I'm using H1 tag, then U tag, as well as I want to define some comment tag. So how can I write the comment tag? Let's see, I'm using comment tag, comment, then this is an example of HTML document, and then close this comment tag. And next, now I want to apply some formatting on this paragraph, or we can create one more paragraph here, and I'm simply copying this text. Okay, Control C for copy and paste it here with the Control V, and then slash P. Now I am using here BR tag for break align. BR is an empty tag. Simply we can define the BR tag, and after this paragraph I want to insert one horizontal ruler, so I can use the HR tag. And the attribute we can use like width by default is 100%, but we can define here, let's say 70%. Now we can define the size, let's say in a pixels we can define, let's say 5 pixels, by default it is 3 pixels. And we can also define the color, background color is green. I am using color here white, let's say white. Now after this horizontal ruler, starting the paragraph tag, I am using here font tag, font face equals to, we can use any font name, so you can check the font name and you can select any font name, like let's say Arial, Unicode, MS, and then I'm writing here Control V. Now this is the font name. Next is size. We can define size, let's say I'm defining the size 20, and the color of the font, color let's say in pink. Okay, pink. And first we will close this font tag. Now close body tag first, and then after close HTML tag. Okay, now save this file, save as. I'm save this file within the document.
let's say file name is html lec underscore lecture 2 dot html. Okay, now save this file, open browser. To open a file, my file name was html lecture 2. This is my file. Just click on open button and you can view this output. Now look at here, background color is green. We will check and compare the text and tag. Now bg color green, so you can check it here, the background color is green, text color is yellow. So it means the document text color is yellow. H1 align center. Now you can check the heading appearing in a center. Now comment tag, I'm defining here comment tag. Comment tag is not display. And then after you can check, this is the ruler, horizontal ruler, color in white. And then after we have defined the font tag, within the font tag we have used pink color. So in this way you can create the HTML document and save your file with .html extension. So do this practice. Okay beta, bye bye.